Already, guys, it's me, the almighty D Daragon from YouTube, and today we are unboxing and testing out the Tech 21 Evo Check phone case. It has a drop protection of 12 feet, has antimicrobial protection, which apparently it cleans itself overnight after hitting certain surfaces. So, depending on how, I guess, unhygienic the area is, it would actually self-clean itself once you bring it into a hygienic area, such as your home, I'd assume, if you actually take care of your place. Anyway, I currently have been using between my leather case, but which I'd like to say isn't the most hygienic during these times, so I switched recently back to my Spigen first one. Really wanted a case that had more drop protection and that I could see like a sticker right through it. So as you see right here, I got this from like a eBay seller, which is quite awesome. However, the drop protection on this to me isn't the best. It is a nice case. I've never done a video on this one because it was my first case, but it's pretty good. The bumper sides don't really have much, so I'd be afraid if I really dropped it down somewhere really important. But you know, we can't always worry about stuff like that. So let's take a look at the Evo Check. It's quite a similar layout, as you see. I actually got this from a authorized seller on Amazon, which this is technically refurbished, but it said it was like brand new. So it actually comes with the mix and match buttons. You could swap the buttons. So like if I wanted the yellow one, maybe I'll show it for you guys because I have yellow text right here. And I did want to see how transparent it is to put a sticker or a decal, because I am ordering another decal that I did want to put behind it to customize my phone. But we'll see how it actually looks. So basically, it's stuck in here like this, and you pull it out and you customize the buttons. I'd assume they just push out like so. Yeah, they push out like so. You should probably be pretty careful with these, and they come out like this, so that's pretty cool. And then if I want yellow, which I guess I'll tear this apart, we'll take a look at how they look at the side, and you just push them in inward, and then it looks like that. So I'm going to switch it into this case, but as you see right here, it does have a big rubberized grip. This is why I love Tech 21. I had it for my XS Max. The cutouts are pretty damn perfect. The button swaps are new, I believe, to this build, because I don't remember that in my last one. I did buy my other case brand new, and the check marks are more spread apart compared to last time. So it's quite an interesting texture. It's not really that bothersome, I'd imagine, on the phone case. So let's take a look. We're going to take it out. Right here, I always have a if found my phone. It has my email, my graphic design email. If you have any graphic design inquiries, feel free to contact me. I should probably be trying to sell myself. Depends on your style. So I'm going to push it in, kind of like so. As you see, the buttons are still pretty clicky. You can probably hear it. Let me see. It actually looks pretty nice with the yellow buttons at the side, though it does dim it down a little bit. So maybe you need a brighter yellow to make it look nice. I'm not really a fan of the color options. I feel like they could have gave white or other stuff, but whatever. I'm probably going to just put black back in here. I opened it for you guys. And then you could also swap this one, which I just felt like showing you one. The cutouts are really good. Has a little branding on the side. If branding bothers you, then probably not the phone case for you. The cutouts right here are pretty much perfect, as you'll see. And I assume it's like, doesn't have that much sweat. And you have enough room to mute and unmute, which is always important to me, is when you have a case, it's easy to mute and unmute. Otherwise, it becomes a pain in the ass. And then as you see right there, it has enough room to cover the camera. Maybe should be a little bit more. It's good enough, I believe. And then right here, you can see how much cutout it has for the actual screen protector, which is a lot more than the leather case I've been using. So, and it curves upwards towards the edge of the screen, so gives a little bit extra protection on those edges. And the cutout for the screen protector, if you get really cheap ones like me, sometimes you feel it when you're swiping up with those leather cases. So it gets really, really annoying. So on this case, you don't really have enough room to actually feel the edge of the screen protector. Overall, though, I gotta say, it's pretty damn nice case. It has good bezels. You color swap the buttons if you really want, if you want to put some yellow behind it. And yeah, it's very grippy. And if you squeeze hard enough, you can feel the cushion. But you gotta squeeze like insanely hard just to feel it. But it has way more cushion than this for size comparison. It's a little bit thicker in almost all aspects. You'd probably notice it more when having it like that. So you can see the edges are a little wider on it because it does give that extra cushion. So that is pretty good. Cutouts are probably similar. Cutouts are insanely similar. Except with that one, it is a little bit smaller. But because this is a lot thinner case, the Spigen one, it was still pretty easy to press the mute button. So this is a good alternative if you don't want to go with Tech 21. But overall, so far, it seems like it'll be a good case. So this is a quick look at the Tech 21 Evo Check case. Let me know what you guys think down below if you have it. If not, hopefully this video helped you out in some way or another. This is me, the Almighty D. Darragon from YouTube. Deuces. I'm outie.